About 250 miles north of Chicago, Door County is Wisconsin's premier vacation destination, offering visitors of all ages outdoor fun combined with great food, performing arts, shopping, and of course, natural beauty. A peek inside the door is where you will get a glimpse of the people, places, and activities on the Door County, Wisconsin Peninsula. Produced by DoorCountyNavigator.com, Door County's largest independent travel destination website. After the show, head to DoorCountyNavigator.com, where our trusted reviews and videos have been leading people to the best in Door County for over 12 years. In this episode, we investigate the Door County music scene with singer-songwriter Chris Irwin. Let's take a peek inside the door.
The Birchwood Lodge is one of Door County's premier lodging choices. Located in the heart of the peninsula on top of the hill in Sister Bay, this clean and comfortable resort offers 46 luxurious non-smoking suites, each including a huge deck, two-person jacuzzi whirlpool, fireplace, and kitchen facilities. The spacious lobby includes a game room and exercise facility just steps away from the indoor and outdoor pools. For longer stays, larger groups, or if you just want to spread out in comfort, the Birchwood Lodge Village Homes offers quiet privacy with all the resort amenities just outside your door. A special feature of the Birchwood Lodge is the restored historic farmhouse, perfect for a family that would enjoy a vintage experience with all the modern comforts, including Wi-Fi, flat-screen TVs, and whirlpool, together with a comfortable farm family kitchen table where you can gather and review the events of the day. The Birchwood Lodge is an ideal location and perfect choice for your Door County vacation, business retreat, or special event.
And this is Access Door County, your window to arts and entertainment. Today I'm sitting out here with Mr. Chris Irwin.
Young lovers
and
in the tall
he is one of many Door County artists who has been performing around Door County for a number of years. Chris comes to us by way of Tennessee, out of California, and summers up here from time to time and then performs with a vast variety of arts and entertainment people here in Door County. Chris, welcome.
Thank you.
Chris, I guess the first question I'd say, why Door County?
The first person who told me about Door County was Fred Alley, who was the co-founder of AFT, and he was like the greatest salesman in the world. He's like, Door County is the greatest place ever, and so he convinced me to come up here, and I've been coming up ever since, like 14 years, so.
14 years of
it's pretty cool.
The beautiful Door County, and by the way, which is really bizarre, because I just did an interview with Eli Mattson, actually on the exact same lake, which is Kangaroo Lake, just a little further up north this time. But evidently, this is where the arts and entertainment area is. How long have you been playing?
I started when I was about 10 or so.
Okay.
And then I've been playing, I did theater and stuff for about 20 years.
Okay.
So I've been playing professionally probably since the late 80s. Off and on, you know, but my first year up here was 97.
Okay.
So,
I noticed that whomever you tend to play with, you just kind of mesh with. Is that just a natural talent of yours, or is it just from the years of playing with different people? What brings about a person being able to just go in, you know, pick up, and you're right there in the group like you've been there forever?
Right. Well, I think a lot of it comes from my theater background, because I did what's called musician's theater. So I would be hired to come in and play bass, like for a production, or guitar. I played piano for Guys on Ice, which was a AFT production. And so I think when you have that kind of background, it's not only do you bounce around on instruments, but also different genres. We're talking about gospel. I did a show called Smoke on the Mountain.
Okay.
It's all a lot of great gospel music. And so, you know, coming from that, like I just did a weekend with the Knicks up on Washington Island where I played bass. So I normally don't play bass that much, okay. But I've done some theater gigs and stuff in the past, and we had charts. And so you just kind of go with the flow, you know, and hope for the best. But it's fun, though. Right. That's really fun to do. Then I did the bluegrass camp up here for a week. So it's great to go from playing a rock gig in a bar to being a bluegrass thing or doing a theater. You know, it's fun to do different things.
One of the big things that's happening now in music in general is you get a lot of people who are doing what they call auto-tuning. Whereas maybe I'm not that great of a singer, but I have a certain look or a certain feel about myself, mm-hmm. and I'm marketable. So I'll sing as best I can, and someone will fix it in the back. What do you think of that? I mean, you've been doing this for a long time. This is not new for you. And it's something that you're passionate about. It's something that you're driven about. And here you have these people who come just out of nowhere, and they're like, oh, well, you know, I really suck in concert, but my CD sounds awesome. What do you say? I mean,
you know, it's about the product. And I think that, sure, you know, if you got a really good-looking girl who sings okay, but they think they can make $50 million off of her record, yeah, they'll go auto-tune the whole thing. But it doesn't matter, you know. It's like, but, you know, what I love artists who will just let it just be organic, you know. We were just listening to some Ryan Adams the other day, who's a songwriter out of North Carolina. He's great. And I mean, and it's just, you know, it's just guitar and vocal, and he's just singing it, you know. And I love that. And that's what I aspire to do, you know, when I make records. Instead of going through and fixing every little tiny thing, which you can do
with
Pro Tools or whatever, I think it's better
just to leave it raw.
Yeah.
I mean, if you're going to do a concert, I mean, you're going to have those errors or not have them anyway, so why set someone up for failure in the first place?
Mm-hmm. But I want to do a new record, okay. Maybe to put out next year. My old one's like 5 years old, so it's time for a new one, and it's going to be all original, and so that will take a lot of work, you know, just to put that together. But hopefully, stay tuned.
Well, we look forward to that. I think it's going to be cool, because like I said, the things that I did hear from you when, you know, looking you up on the internet and different things and stuff was incredible. I mean, honestly, it really was, and I just admire the fact that you're a genuine individual. You love what you do, because you don't find that a lot. You find people who get bored with it, they get tired with it, and you just really seem to be, you know, thriving on the fact that, okay, you know what, I've got a full-time job. I don't mind coming here and laying back, and all I'm thinking about is music and hanging out with music people in that industry, and I think that's beautiful.
Yeah, it's great, and I feel so fortunate to get to do it, you know. I mean, it's just, what's better to come up here and play music and...
Well, what better place to do
awesome.
It?
It's awesome. Yeah.
There's so much music and arts, and just in general, here in Door County, it just completely blows me away, the amount of talent. I mean, when I moved here, I couldn't believe the amount of young people and bands that are just wake up overnight and there they are playing, and they're really good. What would you say would be a way, because I mean, this is just something that I'm pretty sure many people have been thinking about, of being able to market that, to let people know that, you know what, it's not about California, and not to knock California, and not to knock Chicago, and not to knock New York, but right here in little town, you know, United States, you know, there are so many talent. How do you market that? How do you get it out there that, you know what, let's go to these little towns and get this little talent out of here?
You know, a lot of people might think, well, if I have an awesome song or whatever, and I put it out there, suddenly it'll take off, and sometimes that happens, but I think having a community, you know, being a part of a community, and stuff like, you know, bands like the Knicks, and so like when we play Fish Stock and stuff, and people will videotape it, they'll throw it on YouTube, you know, then it starts to kind of roll a little bit, and that's part of it, I think. You know, just kind of like I was saying earlier, just kind of doing what you can where you are and get that going, and you can kind of branch off from there. You know, it kind of, that enthusiasm will branch out into other areas, hopefully.
Parkwood Lodge has all of the amenities and comforts you expect at a price you will appreciate. This 10-acre resort features 60 comfortable, air-conditioned, spacious hotel rooms with cable TV and in-room coffee makers. Choose from king or queen-size beds in one- or two-room suites with fireplaces or wood-burning stoves and convenient kitchen facilities. Enjoy the heated indoor pool and whirlpool year-round. Get some exercise on our tennis court or relax and visit in the warm glow of our cozy fire pit. Kids love our game room, and you'll love the fact that they can bike around the property and play on our swing set while you keep a watchful eye from your patio nearby. Parkwood Lodge is centrally located just north of Fish Creek with easy access to shops, restaurants, and all of the favorite Door County attractions. Make yourself at home. Call Parkwood Lodge today to begin your Door County vacation. Treasure Map Contest, where you might win a Door County getaway. We want to know what you think about the show, and if there's any specific information you'd like us to include. We produce a new Peek Inside the Door episode every month. Your comments and suggestions may be used in a future episode, so visit us online at doorcountynavigator.com/TV.
Embracing the rich heritage and famous hospitality of the Scandinavian countries, Scandinavian Lodge is proud to continue in the traditions and history in Door County. Ideally located on Highway 57 at the entrance of Sister Bay, Scandinavian Lodge's unique setting can accommodate a romantic and peaceful getaway for two to a serene and spacious place for family and friends to gather. This is a lovely place for honeymoons, family vacations, weddings or reunions, or just a place to spend special time with friends. The Scandinavian Lodge offers romantic studios, 1, 2, and 3-bedroom condos. All units are equipped with a kitchen, gas fireplace, patio or balcony, and jacuzzi double whirlpool bath. The Scandinavian Lodge offers an indoor and outdoor pool, indoor whirlpool, children's pool, and sauna. We also have a fantastic fitness and game room, tennis court, playground, and so much more. For great seasonal specials and rates, please call 1-888-64-LODGE or check us out at www.scandinavianlodge.com.
Any day is a good day to head for Fred and Fuzzy's Waterfront Bar and Grill. This popular indoor-outdoor eatery brings visitors and locals together in a casual atmosphere reminiscent of a backyard party. Fred and Fuzzy's is a perfect place to meet old friends or make new friends while enjoying the stunning view of Green Bay from the shores of Little Sister Resort.
The view is just incredible, and so the food is good, and the view is good, and what else can you say? You come here in the summer and you watch sunsets.
Open for lunch and dinner, no trip to Door County is complete without kicking back and relaxing for a time at Fred and Fuzzy's Waterfront Bar and Grill.
Let's look at a 5-year scenario for Chris Irwin. What are we going to be doing in 5 years, Chris?
Well, I'm glad you asked, because I was going to make up some lie about going to Mars or something, but I think what I'd really like to do is just take it one step at a time. As far as the music goes, I think I'd like to keep writing. Okay. Keep working on originals. I love all the cover stuff. That I play a lot of bluegrass and country, you know, Hank Williams, stuff like that, and I love that. I always want to do some of that, but I want to do more of the original stuff, and have a band that can back me up on it, where we're really solid. My friend Claudia just came out, and she's so good, and the guys, everything that they do is very specific. It's not necessarily that flashy or anything. Okay. It just fits the song, you know, and that's what I aspire to. I want whatever we do arrangement wise to just be able to support the song.
Okay.
So I would say, you know, just want to hopefully be still coming up here and hanging out and playing and having a good time and sailing and also, you know, I want to get some music going out on the West Coast and start. You know, I've done a little bit in Hollywood, and I'd like to do more in Southern California and do more in the Bay Area where I live. And hopefully, you know, be sitting here 5 years later and be a couple of new good records, and that would be fine by me.
That's right. Sitting right out on Kangaroo Lake. Enjoying
you bet.
Those,
absolutely.
Those times. Well, I definitely want to keep you because I want to hear. I'm sure the people would love to hear something from you and be able to, you know, just enjoy that moment. So if you wouldn't mind, I'd love to, you know, get you to play something.
Okay, I can do that. Well, this is my new song. It's called Shelter. And, you know, it's about going through tough times and having good friends to help you through tough times, love, that sort of thing. Anyway. My shelter, let's just sit together. The pain I feel in this moment, it won't last forever. All the questions of my story fly above me now, ever circling in the shadows. They make it hard to see just what you mean to me. But if I could have just one day, we could walk together. I could see you on your way. You know somehow that's better.
The Shoreline Restaurant, located in Gill's Rock at the very tip of the peninsula, is a perfect place for a casual meal or special occasion. You can enjoy a relaxing beverage in the Shoreline Lounge or a cozy dinner while overlooking the sparkling waters of Green Bay. Specializing in seafood and open for lunch and dinner, don't leave Door County without experiencing a memorable meal at the scenic Shoreline Restaurant.
This life is over, I'll fly away to that place on God's celestial shore. I'll fly away, I'll fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away in the morning when I die, hallelujah, by and by. I'll fly away when, let's see, I can't remember the second verse. Just a few more weary days and then
I'll fly away
to a place where joys will never end. I'll fly away. Well, I'll fly away, oh glory. I'll fly away in the morning when I die. Hallelujah, by and by. I'll fly away. Oh, I'll fly away, oh glory. I'll fly away in the morning when I die. Hallelujah, by and by. I'll fly away. Well, I'll fly away. All right. Right, thank you, sir.
Chris,
that was
Irwin.
Fun.
I've been here today with Chris Irwin, a beautiful songwriter, musician, singer, extraordinaire. People, if you have not had an opportunity to get out and see this man live, you need to get out and see him. And I guarantee you he'll be here next year. And if he doesn't, I'll hunt him down. I'm Hervey Hodges, standing here with Chris Irwin. Thank you for watching. Thank you.
The Birchwood Lodge is one of Door County's premier lodging choices. Located in the heart of the peninsula on top of the hill in Sister Bay, this clean and comfortable resort offers 46 luxurious non-smoking suites, each including a huge deck, two-person jacuzzi whirlpool, fireplace, and kitchen facilities. The spacious lobby includes a game room and exercise facility just steps away from the indoor and outdoor pools. For longer stays, larger groups, or if you just want to spread out in comfort, the Birchwood Lodge Village Homes offers quiet privacy with all the resort amenities just outside your door. A special feature of the Birchwood Lodge is the restored historic farmhouse, perfect for a family that would enjoy a vintage experience with all the modern comforts, including Wi-Fi, flat-screen TVs, and whirlpool, together with a comfortable farm family kitchen table where you can gather and review the events of the day. The Birchwood Lodge is an ideal location and perfect choice for your Door County vacation, business retreat, or special event.
Door County Interiors and Design is the one-stop home store for Door County, Wisconsin. Offering a full line of furniture, lamps, decorative accessories, gifts, window treatments, carpets, and a selection of over 10,000 fabric choices. Designers are available to assist you with your decorating projects and advise you in selecting flooring and tile. Whether you're remodeling or building, need a new sofa, or just looking for the right accent piece to decorate your home or vacation property, visit Door County Interiors, conveniently located on Highway 42 in Egg Harbor.
We're anxious to hear from our Peek Inside the Door viewers. Visit doorcountynavigator.com/TV to leave a comment. While you're there, you can also register for our treasure map contest, where you might win a Door County getaway. We want to know what you think about the show, and if there's any specific information you'd like us to include. We produce a new Peek Inside the Door episode every month. Your comments and suggestions may be used in a future episode. So visit us online at doorcountynavigator.com/TV.
Embracing the rich heritage and famous hospitality of the Scandinavian countries, Scandinavian Lodge is proud to continue in the traditions and history in Door County. Ideally located on Highway 57 at the entrance of Sister Bay, Scandinavian Lodge's unique setting can accommodate a romantic and peaceful getaway for two to a serene and spacious place for family and friends to gather. This is a lovely place for honeymoons, family vacations, weddings or reunions, or just a place to spend special time with friends. The Scandinavian Lodge offers romantic studios, 1, 2, and 3-bedroom condos. All units are equipped with a kitchen, gas fireplace, patio or balcony, and jacuzzi double whirlpool bath. The Scandinavian Lodge offers an indoor and outdoor pool, indoor whirlpool, children's pool, and sauna. We also have a fantastic fitness and game room, tennis court, playground, and so much more. For great seasonal specials and rates, please call 1-888-64-LODGE or check us out at www.scandinavianlodge.com.
Parkwood Lodge has all of the amenities and comforts you expect at a price you will appreciate. This 10-acre resort features 60 comfortable, air-conditioned, spacious hotel rooms with cable TV and in-room coffee makers. Choose from king or queen-size beds in 1 or 2-room suites with fireplaces or wood-burning stoves and convenient kitchen facilities. Enjoy the heated indoor pool and whirlpool year-round. Get some exercise on our tennis court or relax and visit in the warm glow of our cozy fire pit. Kids love our game room, and you'll love the fact that they can bike around the property and play on our swing set while you keep a watchful eye from your patio nearby. Parkwood Lodge is centrally located just north of Fish Creek with easy access to shops, restaurants, and all of the favorite Door County attractions. Make yourself at home. Call Parkwood Lodge today to begin your Door County vacation.
About 250 miles north of Chicago, Door County is Wisconsin's premier vacation destination, offering visitors of all ages outdoor fun combined with great food, performing arts, shopping, and of course, natural beauty. DoorCountyNavigator.com will help you find the perfect place to stay, play, and dine, providing all the resources you'll need to plan your trip. Be in the know before you go. Whether you're searching for a cozy mystery to read by the fire or a nonfiction book to keep you informed on your commute to and from work, Author Showcase is produced in Chicago and is using video to introduce readers to new books and report on what is happening in the world of publishing. Tune in to Author Showcase every Thursday at 8 p.m. on Chicago Cable Channel 25 or see us online at authorsbroadcast.com.